As soon as you get the meals,
amen.
Go to the mail. Come on, folks, ain't going to the mailbox. My God, you get the you see it's a meal. That joker says, "Shut off." This time the judge says, "Oh God, you've been good to me." Oh, somebody.
Amen.
Because you're letting God know, in spite of whatever I'm dealing with, I know you're still able. Come on, somebody. I know that any day now, any minute now, you're going to show up in my finances. Any minute now, you're going to make my baby kids act right. Any minute now, come on, somebody. You're going to bring me exactly what I need. Any minute now, somebody say, any minute now. Here's the matter. He went through his brothers, didn't like him. Elder, they didn't like him. And here it is, they're his own blood brothers. Come on, somebody. Look at your neighbor and say, "Neighbor, for real, though. Do you really like me?" God, don't matter no way, don't matter. God, I hear you. God, I hear you. Somebody gonna like this, but you have to put yourself in a place to whether if don't nobody like you, you still gonna serve God. And the reason they can't get with you, and the reason they don't like you, is because you serve God. All right, y'all come on, somebody. Not because you did something to them. Come on, somebody. They don't like you because you done got delivered now. Are y'all hearing me? Ain't no more sneaking out to church no more. Doing something that you ain't got no way. Ain't no more of that no more. You don't like me because I changed. Oh, I changed it. So what? I'm living for God for real. I ain't buying the weed no more. Come on, somebody.
Then anyone had nothing left to do with you.
for somebody. Let the being sold out being thrown in prison. Tell your neighbor, even though I'm in my storm, I still got favor. It is amazing. I'm almost done. It is amazing to have favor even when you're going through. This, but this little glimpse of favor lets you know I'm still here. Right here in the middle of whatever you're going through, I want you to know that I'm still with you. Ask the three Hebrew boys, come on somebody, right when they were in the furnace, come on, Jesus showed up and let them know I'm still with you. Right here in the middle of this. Went to prison. Watch this. Favor fell on him. He ended up going to the house with the crazy woman. Come on, somebody. Watch this. What is that? What do you say, Bishop? Even though you're anointed and you have favor, the devil will still put somebody on your trail. To make you mess up. Watch this. God, I hear you. You ain't too anointed for temptation. Brother, he'll bring you just what you like. Come on, somebody. Oh my God. He'll give you just what you like. Don't get nervous, it's all right, just, it's for play, it's for play. Watch, he won't bring you something you don't like. Come on, somebody, it's easy to say no if you look like a bugaboo. Come on, somebody, no, no thank you.
Spirit of God.
pray and ask God for?
Come on, Bishop.
Come on, somebody. Come on, you want to talk? Come on. You want to have that good hair? Come on, somebody. I don't know, you might want an African. I don't know what you want. My wife. My mom wife. That's my wish. I don't know. But whatever you pray for, watch this. The devil will make them for you. And some of you, God, I hear you. This restoration. Come on, somebody. Because you're getting ready to be restored back into your right mind. Come on, somebody. Oh, God. But some of you, you prayed and the devil made them for you. Come on. And then let me tell you something. A counterfeit will always come before the real thing. As soon as the devil sent that joker, you're talking about, look, I ain't gonna look at God. Look, I didn't hear the Lord. No, you heard your flesh. You didn't hear your flesh. I'm going here. You can tell when one of the saints gets somebody in their life, especially if they're in the same church with them. Or just come to visit. Come on, somebody. You can tell. You know why? Because they don't praise God like they normally praise God. They don't pray. Come on. Let him come and visit. Come on, your church. With you. Come on, all that shouting you used to do. Come on. Wait, let me help you. But you want a man that don't mind worshiping and praising God, but when he comes, you don't do it. You in here, I'm in your kitchen making grits right now. Come on, somebody. Because watch this. This is how you know whether it's God or not. Because when God, I don't even know where I'm going here. When God brings somebody in your life that was sent by him, you're not afraid to praise your Savior in front of them. Come on, somebody. Oh, God. Because that thing that you're doing for God makes you attractive to them. With her, she's trying to get him. She's trying to get him. He said no. He said no. She said yes. He said no. She said yes. Grab his clothes. He runs up out his clothes. Come on, somebody. I'm gonna say it again. He runs up out his clothes to get away from the enemy. Y'all missed that. He leaves his stuff to get away from the enemy. What do you say, Bishop? Some of you put too much value in your stuff, so you stay around the enemy because you don't want to leave your stuff. Y'all still ain't getting this. You want to keep your stuff, so you keep the devil too. Are y'all hearing me? God say, forget your stuff, because I can give you everything brand new anyway, and get up out of there. I can't leave. I got too much stuff out here. I made too much of an investment. I invested too much in this. And I can't leave. No. When God gives you a way of escape, you better get out of here. Just like Joseph, guess what he did? He got up out of there. Even though, God, I hear you. Don't worry about the backlash when you leave. Come on, somebody. Because people are going to talk. Whenever you decide to do the will of God, people are going to something. Oh God, some of y'all in here quit trying to please everybody. Oh God, you are awake. Somebody, let me tell you something. Somebody, Bishop, is always mad at me. But how can? Since the last time we were here, we just bought another church building. Since the last time we were here, and some of the church didn't like it. But I knew what I heard God say. They got mad. Come on, somebody. And they figured out if enough of them got mad, I would change my mind. That's why I said, I looked at all of them, I love y'all, but so what? We going over here where God lives.
Yes. Amen.
Are y'all hearing me?
Yes.
You don't let people, you don't let things, you don't let stuff stop you from doing the will of God. I'm still in the book. Don't you let, are you hearing me, prophet? Don't you let nobody, come on somebody, you let nobody distract you from doing the will of God. Sit down somewhere for the Holy Ghost and the anointing of God get you. Come on, somebody. It ain't like he's doing this all of a sudden. I wonder where. It don't matter. You're going to either follow the leader or you ain't. You're going to either follow the leader or draw God or drive to Portland for church. Come on, what's that? So she went, grabbed his clothes, he ran. She lied. God, I'm almost out, I promise. She lied. No, she lied. She said, he tried to do something to me. Let me tell you something. Did you not know Jezebel is an actor? She's a good actress. Come on. I'm going to say it again. Because I know somebody don't like you. So I'm saying again, I'm stepping on your feet twice. Jezebel, that's a good actress. Come on, somebody. Jezebel always wants somebody to have pity on her. Always. You can't never, yeah, I ain't one of those things because I don't know who it is. I'm just visiting. Listen, you ever come to church? Now there's one person in church you don't really like speaking to. Not because you don't like them, but because every time you speak to them, and you say, hey, Sister Slewfoot, how you doing? And Sister Slewfoot say, well, I'm okay. You know, things ain't been good. It make you not even want to ask them. What's up? Come on, somebody. Everybody speaking in tongues. Come on, somebody. Prophecy went forth. Get out church. Slewfoot in the back pew. So, Slewfoot, you enjoy the service? Well, I couldn't really praise him like I want to. Always. Have an issue. Come on, somebody. My wife helped me preach over here. Why? Because you got those, and I know leadership can attest to this, you got those that always want your attention. You ain't even getting a night, is you? Okay. Always want the leadership attention. Something is always wrong. I said, I might have two churches. Those of you who come in, this side, over here, with a wall, with the door, but can't nobody hear you? That's for the people that always got issues. And when you come to church, when I say always issues, it's always the same thing every time I see you. And this side is for those that want to praise your way out of it. Bishop, you can't be mean like that. You can't be mean like that. Let me tell you something. You can't make anybody get delivered if they don't want it. All they're going to do is waste your time. Did y'all hear what I said? Let me tell you something. You didn't come to God until you got ready. Come on, somebody. I'm trying to tell you, you didn't come to God until you got free. One more second. So, go. Let's let you know. Now, he runs. He gets thrown back in jail, but he still has favor. Tell you, whatever happens to you, it doesn't matter. Because you're going to always have favor. Always. Go in jail. Here he is again. What happens? Watch this. His gift kicks in. Again. He knew somebody in jail was the baker. Come on, somebody. And some other folk he knew. I'm almost done. Some other folk that he knew that was in jail with him, watch this, that kind of had a little favor with the king. Come on, somebody. But sometimes, how many of them, God may not take you right to your miracle. He may put you in touch with somebody that know your miracle. Y'all messing this. Did y'all hear what I said? He may put you in touch with somebody that know your miracle. Come on, somebody. So the baker went back to him. He had a dream. He said, I need an interpreter. I don't know what this means. So he called and he sent for him and he came and he interpreted his dreams. And through that, watch this, it opened up the door to him becoming second in command. Are y'all hearing me? He said to him, you can do everything that I can do. Y'all missing this. You can do everything that I can do. You can do everything that I can do. Are y'all getting this? You can do everything. I give you the power to do everything that I can do. I'm almost done. What are you saying, Bishop? My God, even though you did not know Jesus for yourself, you ran into somebody that knew him. Come on, somebody. And then God decided to allow you to get close to him. And next thing you know, he started telling you, you can do everything that I can do. So he took your private struggle. How many of y'all been through hell and hot water? Tell the truth. Matter of fact, some of you don't even know how you're here today. You made it and don't even remember. Come on, somebody. How you got to this point in your life? You ever been driving on the freeway and you had so much on your mind, you looked up and you were somewhere, you don't even know how you got there? Come on, you drive and you miss your exit. Come on, somebody, because y'all know y'all did it. Come on, somebody. You got so much on your mind and now you got to go back 2 extra miles because you done passed your exit because your mind is flooded with all kind of stuff. Come on, somebody. My God, you've been passing by everything in your life, but God said, I'm getting ready to give you more than what you had before. You struggled. I'm getting ready to bless you now. You went through. I'm getting ready to bless you now. Somebody receive this blessing right now. Now, he's getting ready to put you where everybody can see you. Bishop said something when he got up there today. He said something about not being on the map or being known or seen. Let me tell you something. Sometimes God will hide you on purpose. Watch this. But when it's time for exposure, you better be ready. Are y'all hearing me? And through this elevation that's getting ready to happen for your mission, watch this. Now God is getting ready to allow Salem, Oregon, come on, to be known, the capital where God lives. Come on, somebody. Are y'all hearing me? And it's going to start right here in this ministry. Revival is going to break out. And oh God, it ain't just going to hit Oregon, but it's going to gonna cross thick lines. Come on, somebody. Oh, I wish I had somebody in here. Oh, it's gonna cross thick lines. It's gonna go from state to state. Are y'all hearing me? And everybody gonna know whose seed of faith is. Everybody gonna know that the power of God lies in this ministry. They're gonna fly in just to get healed. Ready. Give you a public blessing. That's what he's getting ready to do. Somebody smile because you can. Just smile. He's going to give you a public blessing. And the enemy ain't going to be able to do nothing about it. Come on, somebody. I know y'all look warm. I know y'all look tired. But I'm telling you right now, everyone under the sound of my voice, the anointing of God is getting ready to hit this house like it ain't never hit it before. Y'all thought y'all was having a church. Come on, somebody. God is getting, oh my God. God is getting ready to do, and oh God, I hear you. And for everybody that don't want to do right, glory to God. God will send somebody to take your place. Watch what I tell you.
Hallelujah.
So he goes before King. Your anointing, prophet, your anointing, woman of God, it's going to take you before the king. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
And the king is going to find favor with you. Are y'all hearing me? So the very ones that sold you out is going to need you. Y'all missing this. Huh? We know the story. The very ones that sold you out is going to need you. I don't know why I'm going here. Let me tell you something. One of the worst feelings, it's a horrible feeling to me at least, is when you take somebody in your house and you love them, you feed them, you clothe them, and when they leave, they talk about you. Y'all quiet tonight. That's one of the worst feelings. Did all this,
yes.
And you still left and ran my name in the ground.
My God.
Watch this. Those same ones is going to end up back at your door. Yeah. Oh, you hear me? It's going to end up back at your door. Come on, somebody. When I found this out, Bishop, I got excited, but I was a little concerned at the same time. And my reaction is because the Lord told me, he said, there are going to be some that are going to be on their deathbed. Oh, come on, somebody. And they're going to know that all they need to do is call Bishop Golden. Come on, somebody. To get that kingdom off of them. Are y'all hearing me? And when they call me, glory to God, I said, God, when they call me, let me go. Come on, don't be deep on me in here. Because you know some of y'all, if somebody do you wrong, you can see them on the side of the road. Come on, somebody.